Ladies and gentlemen, come gather round, come gather round, come gather all round. Today, we're dusting off my little Super 7 replica to clean some injectors. I cut up an 86 Corolla GTS just to make this car. Sort of regret it, then again, sort of don't. These injectors, far as I know, have not been cleaned since 1986, and it's now 37 years later. I think it's time to clean them. So, let's go!
First step is to get the engine hood off, and then we're going to get the injectors out. These are the Bosch style clips. I hate these. I've always hated these. If you know the trick that can easily and quickly disconnect these, let me know. I'm all ears. Leave a comment below, because I hate trying to undo these. I've always hated them, even when they were new. I just found taking the rail off and yanking them out worked better for me.
I bought this fuel injector cleaner machine a couple years ago because I was doing a turbocharged Chevy LS. And one of the things you can do is decap the injectors. It means removing the diffuser off the end of here, and they flow 2.5 times more fuel. And it was cheaper for me to buy this machine and test a slew of injectors until I got a matching set than it was to ship them all out to a company to clean them for me. So it's a bit of a gamble. I bought the machine because it seemed cost effective at the time. We're gonna do these Toyota injectors, but first we need to see how they flow at the moment. So I gotta load this thing up with some juice. Here we go.
So this thing won't actually measure the actual full flow of your injectors, but the gradients will help you at least compare different injectors with each other, which is really all I'm after. I'm using mineral spirits as a solution to run through this. It seems to be pretty good for not foaming up, and it doesn't harm the injectors, but it works. It's basically a paint thinner that's pretty mild.
Well, it's not actually all that bad. So we've got, looks like a 40 and a 40 and probably a 38 and a 40. That's actually more of a 38. 38 and a 40. That's not bad. That's actually not bad. Just do that again. All right. 40. 38. Number 36, maybe. And 40. Maybe a 39. All right. Now we're going to clean them. So the back of this, the top of this, comes with a little ultrasonic cleaner. So I'm going to use sea foam to clean these. Just because that's what I have, and it actually works pretty good. So, a little bit of this, there's probably others, this is what I have. What matters is there's ultrasonic shaking these out. So, ultrasonic cleaning would be number one. So I let this run for about two hours, actually, just because I want to make sure. I lay them on their side for a while and ultrasonically clean them, and then I set them back up on end. Now we're going to reverse flush them, run them backwards through here, and then we'll give them a little test and see how they do.
I don't know if there's any difference in the way the machine operates for reverse flushing. You just hook it all up. It pulses the injectors, except you hook them up backwards so it pukes everything out of the injector that got collected inside the injector. Usually a good idea. I have no idea if there's a filter inside the machine for filtering all the stuff that comes out. So it might be an idea to put one in if there isn't. If I were to upgrade this at all, I would probably use a better fuel pressure regulator and a better quality fuel pump. I do find if you're testing a lot of injectors, this thing, it kind of doesn't like the heat and it starts to lose pressure over time. For this, with just four, it was reasonably consistent. I didn't raise the fuel pressure at all. I just kept whatever the default was and it worked fine. And I ran this through all of its different settings. There are a variety of different tests you can do. There's your idling test, which is a relatively low injector pulse width. And there's a medium speed test, a high speed test. There's an acceleration test where it ramps itself up through ever increasing speeds or faster pulse widths. There's a shifting speed test. There's a leak checking test where it just gives you pressure but does not pulse the injectors. And that's where I found injector number three had a bit of an issue. Number three here was consistently low and the cleaning didn't help it. It had a crack on the plastic tip on there. It didn't seem to be functionally an issue, but it sure did not flow consistently any better. It was always lower than the rest. And I ran it through a couple other tests. There's a spray value test that I guess I'm not sure exactly what it does, but you can choose it. And I forget what it does. So I just did it through all and I look for anything that's different between all of them. And I run it through the paces and see if I can find a difference. When I was doing Chevy LS injectors, I had 8 that came with my 6-liter, and then I went to the junkyard and bought 16 more injectors, and I flowed all of them and tried them every which way and ultrasonically cleaned them until eventually I found 8 that matched. And if you had to farm that out to get somebody to do that, that can get pretty pricey. Here I'm messing with the third injector to see if I can figure out why. And then I think I broke the plastic cap off the end and then decided, you know what, I don't really care. So I have a little container of Honda Accord injectors, which are rated at more CCs, more flow. They're 245. And so I ran these to see how they did. I ran them on my favorite flow test, I think, which is the high speed test, and they flowed significantly more than the Toyota ones and were a little more consistent. So I ultrasonically cleaned them on their sides, on the end, gave them a good thorough clean, and then ran them through a barrage of testing as well after backflowing. And I was happier with these injectors versus the Toyota ones. They do pretty much fit. They're about the same size, and they seem to work fine. I've run them before in this fuel injection computer. As an aside, for normal vehicles, you can't mess with a computer. You cannot just change injectors. The computer does math based on how big it knows the injector to be. And if you've changed the injector, its math is going to come up with a wrong answer, and you're not going to fuel it properly. So you need to hack the computer to tell it that you've changed the injectors. Putting in new injectors, you should put new O-rings and seals on it so that it seals nicely against the cylinder head or intake manifold and against your fuel rail. Nothing lasts forever. Fresh O-rings are definitely worth their money. And these do get a little bit pricey, but it's a good idea to do those. Again, when I did the LS ones, I wrecked a fair number of injectors trying to do that. Little dab of Vaseline will help these things slippy slide into place, and you're less likely to tear your brand new seals. And then you can reattach the fuel rail, a couple dacadacs with the impact, and then you can reconnect all of your fuel injectors. if I were to do this again, I would move the vacuum sensing pressure regulator thing just to make it easier to get a nut in there. However, it works. It's back together. Now we got to run it. See if it worked.
So I took the old injectors out, ultrasonically cleaned them, back flushed them, fully tested them, wasn't happy with them. Wasn't happy with one. I believe the four AGE injectors are rated at 195 cc's. I had previously run Honda injectors. I pulled out the set of Honda injectors that I had, ultrasonically cleaned those, back flushed, forward flushed, flush, 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 basically flushed everything out of it, and put them in, change the required fuel for the MegSquirt computer so it knows it's got 245 cc injectors now and all should be hunky-dory. So that's it. If you ever want to thoroughly clean your injectors, that's probably the most thorough cleaning you're going to get short of sending it off to somebody who's got a $10,000 ass new machine, which I don't have. So is this injector cleaner worth it? Kind of depends on how many injectors you think you're going to be cleaning. I'm stubborn. So I want to clean them all myself. So I've got it, I've cleaned it, I'm happy. I gotta go get insurance for this so that I can burn off the tank of gas. So as always, thanks for watching. Take care. We'll see you again.